Hello mga kakusina! For today's recipe, we are going to cook roast beef and mashed potatoes. This is very special because it could be one of the main dishes that you can serve for the upcoming holidays. To start off, we're gonna season our beef with just simple salt and ground black pepper, nothing fancy. Dalawang cuts ng beef ang ginamit ko, brisket and kamto or flank steak, because gusto ko po yung medyo may taba-taba ng konti or litid-litid ng konti dahil yun po ang masarap sa roast beef. Now, in a stew pot, ako po ay nagpapainit ng mantika and we're gonna sear our beef after we have marinated it for 30 minutes using the dry rub of salt and ground black pepper. Yung ibang versions po ng roast beef mga kakusina, napansin ko po na pinapakuluan lang po nila yung karne. But I sear mine so that you can actually add another layer of flavor para po talagang inihaw ninyo, kaya nga roast beef ang tawag, ano, parang inihaw na rin ang dating when it comes to the meat itself. Now, when you sear your beef, make sure that your heat is on high para po magkaroon ng crusty color or caramel color sa outer layer ng ating karne. After searing the beef, we're now gonna add water to our pot and make sure lang po na nakalubog ang ating karne. This would ensure even cooking when it comes to tenderizing your beef. Now, kung mapapansin ninyo mga kakusina, before your broth starts to really boil, may lulutang po na impurities dyan or scum na tinatawag. Galing po yan sa ating karne and we wanna remove that from our broth so that hindi po ito magproduce ng malansang amoy or malansang lasa. It took me about 1 hour to fully cook the beef into my desired tenderness. And after cooking, ihihiwalay ko po yung beef. I'm gonna let it cool. And I let it cool inside the refrigerator para po tumigas po siya ng konti. Mas madali po siyang islice. And of course, hindi po siya messing islice para po walang kumakalat na sebo sa ating cutting board. Now, after slicing the beef, we're gonna set that aside and it's now time to make our mashed potatoes. Simple lang po ang paggawa ko ng mashed potatoes, mga kakusina. Pinabalatan ko po muna siya bago ko po siya i-boil. Now, we're gonna boil the potatoes for 15 to 20 minutes and you can test the doneness of the potatoes by poking it with a fork like this. Okay, so luto na ang ating patatas. We're gonna strain off that starchy water and we're gonna start mashing our potatoes while it is hot. And don't forget to add your butter while mashing your potatoes because you want that butter to melt. Kung namamahalan po kayo sa butter, you can use Dairy Cream Classic. Nasubukan ka na po yun and masarap po ang kinalabasan ng ating mashed potatoes using Dairy Cream. Now, we're gonna season this with ground white pepper and of course, salt dahil hindi po tayo naglagay ng salt sa ating tubig kanina. Now, kahit hindi tayo naglagay ng cream or milk sa ating mashed potatoes, you can see it's velvety smooth. That is because we added the butter while it is hot and we were mashing it while it is hot. Next, to prepare ang ating mushrooms, I'm gonna melt butter in a separate pan and we're gonna saute 1 can of whole button mushrooms. Huwag po kayong magugulat sa dami ng butter na ginamit ko because we're also gonna need melted butter later on to drizzle over our roast beef. So pinag-isa ko na lang po para hindi na po tayo separate na magpapamelt ng butter mamaya. Next, bawang naman po ang ipiprepare natin. Magpiprito lang po tayo ng minced garlic para po toppings natin mamaya when we start assembling our roast beef. Next, in a larger pan, tayo po ay magsosote ulit ng bawang, this time with sibuyas naman, mga kakusina, and igigisa na po natin ang ating sliced beef. Now, yung pinagpakuluan po ng ating beef kanina, nilagay ko po yun sa freezer para po tumigas po yung sebo. Madali ko na pong hiniwala yung sebo sa ating broth. And imi-melt na lang po natin yan sa ating pan with the beef and we're gonna let it boil. Kapag kumulo na ang ating beef with the broth, we're gonna add 2 cans of cream of mushroom. Campbell's po ang gamit ko ever since because this gives me the quality that I need and masarap po talaga ito compared to other brands. But it's up to you if you want to use a different brand of cream of mushroom. Now, we're gonna cover this and let it simmer for a few minutes and actually it's done. But for me, I want it to be extra umami, so I added 4 tablespoons of Knorr seasoning. Optional po ito mga kakusina, kung ayaw po ninyong lagyan, okay lang po yun. You can replace it with soy sauce, a little bit of soy sauce, or a little bit more of salt. Now that we have all of the components of our dish cooked, we can start assembling. Family style, this is how I would do it. I'll top the buttered mushrooms after arranging the beef onto a tray, and then we're gonna drizzle it with a little bit of melted butter, and then we're gonna top it with the fried garlic. As for the mashed potatoes, you can place that in a separate serving dish. Kapag ipupwesto nyo siya sa buffet table, itabi nyo lang po sa ating roast beef para alam po ng guests ninyo na magkasama po yon. Now, if you want to serve it individually, ganito po ang serving suggestion na ipre-present ko sa inyo. Underneath, we have the mashed potatoes. On top, we have the roast beef. Dagdagan po ng gravy if you want. Top it with more fried garlic and fresh parsley. So there you have it mga kakusina, another great holiday recipe idea. Sana po ay nagustuhan ninyo ang niluto natin for today. See you again on the next video. Bye now!